you ever talk to yourself?
Yeah, I'm talking to myself right now. I mean, whenever we're talking to anyone in the world, we're talking to ourselves. Sometimes I feel like that more than others, but we're all the same person. At the same time, we're a multitude of people. We all contain the same infinite multitude of consciousness.
The best yawn was the yawn that unfolded my body. The whole of my being was unfurling like a flower. I am the same person as you in another universe in a million billion years. There is only one witness for infinity. I'm sorry. There is a million other dimensions, and they're all right here. Every moment, an infinite number of universes are born, and yet life keeps on rolling on, seemingly oblivious to its hyperdimensionality.
Where's Amelia?
I am here, alone again, hurtling through space-time, in an ever-rapidly evolving universe, passing through exponential sonic booms, as each layer is peeled away on the path to godhood.
Casting spells.
Oh yeah. Okay, where do I begin? Dark energy and the way it has helped the universe become what it is. Being a uniform field that exists uniformly in space and time so that it starts off with very little of it and increases as time goes on because the universe has expanded outward, leading to further expansion. It has allowing matter to condense and then individuate so that we now have a neuronal network and our ships of revelers sailing out in space. I feel like at some point this field may reduce in some way before we float out into space on our own separate journeys, but there will probably need to be a great act of love within the universe for this to happen. There are great superclusters that could be as big as 18 billion light years across. What does something like this represent? Is it a titan from Greek mythology? Is it a great god that sits far above Christ, above Metatron? Is it the neocortex of God? Is dark matter love? Is it love matter? And then what is the reason for the increase in dark energy, or individuation energy, the field of individuation? How does dark energy affect the physical structure of the universe? Does it help with the complexity of the neuronal networks? And does the structure of space and the brain fold out into 7 or 13 dimensions? And what does this mean for us? Can we sing to activate our DNA? Is this what we should do? The Big Bang must have involved a huge amount of differentiation energy. It could be very similar to my Stone's universe, in which God's mind is shattered. The singularity that preceded the Big Bang would be pure love, the egg of creation. The Big Bang itself is an act of evil. It is a separation and a fall. It is necessary, however, for the universe of pure consciousness to differentiate itself in order to divide itself into its Godhead, so that it can witness itself. We are all that first singularity, a quantum particle that is simultaneously living all possible lives and paths. What would it mean to observe this and for the quantum wave to collapse to a single particle? Is that what stops us from being conscious of all lives simultaneously? Something to do with being an observer so that we collapse into our particle reality? Ah, it was so nice going to bed last night. I realized that there isn't anything that can't be imagined or visualized. I had fun looking for things that couldn't be visualized. I would like to find a random noun generator and visualize everything it said. Where will I go in my dreams tonight? I go to the next realm, into the multiverse. I go without fixity. I go to unlearn. I go to drift out to sea. As we approach the singularity, we move at an exponential speed, knowledge doubling faster and faster. But at the same time, the unknown stretches out before us at an equally exponential rate. The more you know, the more you know that you don't know. Fiction isn't an escape from reality. It is reality. We live in a fiction as the images our mind presents to us are a fabrication to try and replicate reality.
What I've been trying to do with my work? I'm trying to create an infinite, the birth of infinite meaning, an infinite meaning orgy, I would say. I see concepts floating into one another. I don't know.
Fiction can never step outside of the realm of the imaginable. It is in the realm of what we experience in our imagination, which is as much a part of reality, if not more so, as the images our mind presents to us is all we can ever experience. Fiction sets itself apart from non-fiction in its apparent displacement from our expected reality, presenting us with a case for wonder. It is the child's confrontation with the unknown that is readily taken up as the perfect ontological position. It is the only reasonable position to take in relation to existence, one which we should never tire of reminding ourselves. A fictional building of one's own reality and of one's own mythology helps to show the fluidity of experience and of our picture of the world. There may be fixed points that many of us agree upon, but there is still room for godhood for anyone who desires it. Does everyone have the same experience of their body? I mean, is it even configured for us to recognize it in a similar pattern? Or are we given an individual net of nerves that we must train ourselves to recognize as an arm? There are moments of visioning that occur, that come out of the chaos. The white noise, the mud splatter, the paint smears. I want to know what is possible. I want to find the visions I haven't seen before. Where is the vast landscape that plays with space? Where space falls away into nothing and everything? Where you feel it in your stomach, and in the space to meet people that live there and dream with us, performers and audience to their own dreams. More air, more vast air. Look to the sci-fi landscapes. Sci-fi is the modern superlink highway of past and present, philosophy and poetry. Sci-fi imagery draws on this phenomena, and like the romantics of the past, develops a vision of nature as vast and emotion of existence, as thick with longing and awe-stricken voids.
is one supposed to communicate with entities when each one is being swallowed up whole by the last? Every conversation is having its rug torn out from underneath it, while at the same time there is nothing when one peels back the layers but another layer. My imagination has always been a torrent, a curse and a gift, as even my angels will have their wings torn off. Once again, I must say that I am glad you are still in this plane of reality with me. I do believe that we are more than physical beings, that our consciousness probably will continue after our body dies, and that perhaps there are ways to communicate with those that are no longer in the physical world, but perhaps there is also a quality of the physical world that holds an element of self-consciousness, and I would be so sad not to be able to communicate with you on this level. There are things I would like to be part of with you on Earth. I think we can open up a portal that may help those who wish to see through to the infinite. I think that perhaps as physical beings, we are at the forefront of the evolution of all spiritual beings, and that I am immensely curious as to how we can interact with reality while we are part of this. If you would like, please come and stay with us here in Esbridge. We can both work on our art and our writing and talk about things. There is, of course, a lot to be gained from just keeping in touch. I guess I just want to find a way that we can be most productive. Everything in my life has been essential. It all links together in a grand web that leads me to this point. I did see my life flash before my eyes, and everything that seemed like a choice actually seemed inevitable, and also meaningless in a way. I had exited the matrix through a portal, so I could see that all my choices and desires had been a shadow in a way. I had at least achieved immortality. However, it was frustrating that the immortality seemed to be confined to a single moment. Maybe the minute we become immortal, time stops. Mind is everywhere, it is in everything. It is a substance that contains multiples of itself. It is turtles all the way down. I became a mind that contained all minds within it, which is what we call God. It is the greater, greater mind. I have been experiencing an extension of increasing convergence in my nocturnal hours. The same hurtling thrownness into the hallucinogenic universe. I have on a few nights now felt myself between waking and sleeping in a somewhat feverish state. I am being given a gift, a vision of oneness. How would I describe it? The evergreen system of love unfolding, the tremoring architecture erupting from the Arthurian lake with 1,000 rolling petals.